Hi, and welcome to How to Make a Game in Unity. This is Straight Up Tech. Let's learn together. In our last episode, we learned how we can collect our collectibles, make them disappear, and update the score. Now, in this episode, we will discuss how you can create a game over screen, and eventually, in any game, a player has to die at some point. So, we will show you how you can create the game over screen and how an another object, which we will name as enemy object, can destroy your player and display the game over screen. So to do that, first of all, what I will do is I'll take my collectibles and or I'll do something better. I'll create a new 3D object and name it as enemy. Now we will be applying almost the same script to the enemy game object as we have applied to the collectible game object, because we want to rotate it, we want to do everything with it which a collectible is doing. But when the player will touch the enemy game object, instead of collecting it, it will destroy the player and the game will be over. So first of all, let me put this enemy at 0.5, that is just over the game space. Then I'll create a new material. Name it enemy, change its albedo to black so it is distinguished from the collectible object and also looks like an enemy. We'll drag and drop it to our enemy game object. Then on enemy, I'll apply the same rotate script, in which what I'm going to do is and make the enemy cube at 45. See? Now again, save it and press play. You see, our enemy object is also moving now. Go out of the screen. Now what we want to do is, whenever our enemy or the player comes in contact with the enemy, we want to restart the game. So to do that, first of all, I will create an empty object and name it game manager object. You can attach the script which I am making to any of the object you want, but for the sake of convenience and clarity, I made a new empty object. So in this object, I am going to create a script named game manager. Now we have our game manager script. I'll double click to open it. Now in this code, we are going to manage our game. Like, we can manage what will happen when the enemy script is collected, what will happen if all the collectibles are collected. You can go to the next level through this script. You can do bunch of stuff from this script. You can create a menu, you can create a pause menu. Everything can be done through the game manager. First of all, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take my enemy game object and tag it as enemy. So again, to do that, I go to tag, add tag, and I have already added the enemy tag, so that's done. I'll just select enemy from it and save the game. Now we will set our enemy game object. As the box collider is already added, we just need to do is trigger. So the script will act only whenever the player or any other object touches this enemy game object. Now, as I have said before, what you want to do is, whenever a player touches the enemy, we want to restart our level. So to do that, first of all, we make a public bool variable and name it as game has ended and give it to false. Now, why do we need a bool variable? Because in the Unity system, when the game ends through your script, it will again end again and again, again and again. So we just want that game should end only once. So to do that, we will pass the bool variable in a condition. So the game will end only once. Now to end the game, we also need the reference to our player movement script, because we want the player movement to end as soon as the game has ended. Game as movement, you know, as public player movement, then movement. So this will create a reference to our player movement's movement. So after we declare our public variable, what we are going to do is we will create a public function and name it end game. So we will call it whenever we want to end our game, and in this function we will check if game has ended equals to false, which is true. I want movement dot enabled equals to false. This will remove, this will stop the player from moving. Then I want to make game has ended to true, so it is not called again. Then I'll create another public function, public void, and name it restart, which will restart the game. Not to restart, what we have to do? To restart, we need to use scene manager, not to use scene manager. We have to call the namespace name scene management. So using Unity engine dot scene management, after that you can use the scene manager function, which will be scene manager dot load scene. This is scene manager dot get active scene dot name. What this will do is this will load the current scene that you are on. So if you are on say level 4 and you approach an enemy and you die, then the level 4 will be restarted. And after that, what we are going to do is we will call this function here start. Now in our player movement script, what we'll do is we will make another on trigger collider event, or we can write else if other dot game object dot compare tag is enemy. What we want to do is we want to call the game with edit function. To do that, we'll do find object of type game manager dot end game. So end game function will be called from the game manager. Let me see, I've written the enemy right. If I select my enemy, nope, I've written wrong. It is E. Okay. Now save the script. Now when we go towards the enemy, see, the game is restarting, but it is doing so very fast. So we have to incur some kind of delay so that it does not feel so unnatural. So to do that, we'll go out of our game, open our game manager script, and we will make a float delay and name it as restart delay for 1 second. After that, I will unmove these comments. So instead of writing restart directly, what we are going to do is we are going to invoke the restart function with a 1 second delay. You can save it, go back to Unity, and now when we press play, you will see, okay, now before restarting, it is taking a 1 second delay. Now what we will do is we will show some kind of game over screen. So to do that, we'll go back to our canvas and make create new UI panel and name it as game over UI. Then in this we'll write a game over text and some thank you note. Now you will have to disable this game over UI and then call it by a function inside your script, because if you do not disable it right now, the game will start with a game over UI already in the game. So the game will be essentially over before even you playing it. So to get the game over UI, only when we want it, we will disable the game over UI. Go back to our script. We'll make a public game object named game over UI, and then we will set that active whenever our game has ended. So once you go back to Unity, in game over UI, you will see, so in our game manager object which we have created to manage our game restarting over starting, in that we have created the script of game manager. In this you will see the game over UI, and you will create a reference to our script in this game over UI by dragging and dropping it inside this. So Now when you play the game and you catch an enemy, see how this game over script is displayed. So this is all for today. Thank you for watching. I hope you will create your own beautiful UI script after watching this. And please don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell icon so you never miss a video from us again.